everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Artistic Blessings with Shawn. That's me. So I'm playing today. I don't have any events coming up. My husband's gone today. Woo! So I was at Goodwill yesterday and I found these really cute little glasses. I guess they could be used for dessert or juice. Some people might use it for a rather large shot glass. But I got a set of four. So I have cleaned them. I just use a little alcohol with a paper towel. It cleans it, gets the sticky, you know, price tags off, and it dries quickly. So that's gonna be helpful. And I just thought I'd invite you along for the process and see how it goes. All right, so let's get started. So step one is I'm actually going to tape off the top of this because, for two reasons. One, if somebody's going to actually drink out of this, we don't want them putting their mouth directly on the paint or the resin, right? And two, this is gonna prevent all of the little drips on the edge as well. At least that's what I'm hoping. All right, so I'm going to do that to all four of them. And then I'll be right back. Okay, so I have them all taped. Just making sure I have pressed down on the edges to make sure those edges are good and tight. Right? And then just an old toilet paper roller. Happens to fit perfectly in there, so I'm just put that right there. I do want to make sure they're level. So I grab my little level. Okay. I should be better prepared. Okay, so I have this cute little level that I picked up on Amazon. Oops, obvious, that's sliding off, so that is obviously not level, guys. So before we pour our paint, we want to make sure they're level. That one looks pretty good. So, I mean, you know me, I like to reuse my things, save the planet as best I can, right? So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna layer my cup. And this is actually what they call a dirty pour, because I'm not gonna layer. I'm gonna make sure that things pierce this thing. So I started out with just some silver by Master's Touch. We're gonna do some green, some Christmas colors. So I've had some green in there and some crimson. My green is by Liquitex Basics. It's a phthalo green. The red is from Artist Loft. Okay, that is probably enough to do one of these. So let's see what this does. I'm gonna start with this one over here. Right. As it drips down, it looks like maybe some of the red didn't get quite in there, so I'm going to add some red here. So, I don't know if I'm 100% happy with that one. The best part is I can always redo it. So I preferred this look. It just needed more red in it. So I think maybe I'm gonna start with red on the bottom and then some silver and then some green. silver and a little more green. Okay, and let's try this one. Okay, that did a little better with getting all three colors in there. I definitely prefer this one. And because I am on my silicone mat that I got from, that I purchased from Lowly Veffy, this, all of these drippings, those are gonna wind up getting turned into some really pretty jewelry. Just so you know. Let's see. I really kind of like this one. This one just didn't make me happy in the end. Okay, so I definitely prefer this look. So let's go with some red in the bottom. Pierce that with some silver, some green, a little more red, a little more silver, a little more green. And let's do this one over here. And one more, start with a little red, pierce that with some silver, get some green in there, a little more red, a little more silver, and a little more green. Okay, starting to run low on the green, it looks like. Okay, and then we'll do this one. There we go. Had to make sure it was going to reach down to the paint. I mean, to the tape. Right. I'm still not sure I like this one. I think we're going to paint right over the top of that one. Not sure I liked how that one turned out. So let's try this again. We started with red. Ooh, I hope I have enough green to do this. Pierce that with the silver. Some green in there, a little more red, a little more silver, and a little more, whoops, a little more green. Okay, because I think we're going to redo this one right here, because I just wasn't happy with how that turned out, guys. Okay, that's going to be better, I think. All right, so I'm going to bring you in and show you what they look like right now from a variety of angles. And then after they're dry, we'll show them to you again. Hold on. Okay, so this is what they look like right now. I'm just trying to move them around here. Don't forget to like, subscribe, ring the notification bell, comment, please, 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 please comment. That does affect the algorithm on YouTube. And remember to share with your friends. Alrighty, if you ever see anything on my channel that you'd like to purchase, just drop me an email. You'll find that down in the description. All you have to do is touch that title and you will be taken to the description. It will pop right up for you. You will also find a link to my website where you can buy prints of the pieces that I do on canvas. And you can find those prints on my merchandise as well. Everything from phone cases to pillows, and all kinds of things in between. All right, I will be back once they're dry. Welcome to the resin room. Let's get started. So I'm using crystal resin today.
just make sure you note that I do have my respirator in here. As much as I hate these things, they are a necessary evil. So I'm gonna get that put on first. Dipped in alcohol just to wipe those off. Okay. My glass is back on. You better? Okay. There we have. So cup one is the hardener. Cup two is the resin. Again, that's just soaked in regular rubbing alcohol to help wipe things off. Okay. Alright. This has a tiny bit more resin in it, so I need to add a teeny tiny tiny bit of the hardener back in. Like just that much. Yeah. Okay. Alrighty. Let's see what I'm doing down here. Alright, the hardener goes in first. Okay, so that's full of little tiny bubbles right now. And so I'm just gonna let it sit here for a minute and see if we can get some of those bubbles to rise to the top. I'm actually gonna use my heat gun just to warm it up a little bit. I don't wanna warm it up. up too much because this is a plastic cup, right? So we don't want it to melt. From a low heat, just trying to warm it up a little bit. It'll thin it out. It'll help some of those bubbles float to the top. All right, let's see if I can get you guys at a better angle. Whoop-dee. Here we go. Okay, and these are just sitting, this is just a toilet paper roll, guys. And I have this taped up to the top so that the mouth, Are we ready? So I'm gonna start by going around the edge a little bit. I wanna get it to start going off the edge. Make sure it's flowing down the edge. And we can help guide this a little bit, just like we do on our paintings, right? If we can get, it'll flow where the rest of it flows. Nice. And some more over here. Look all the way around. I want to make sure that I got from all the way to the edge of that tape. That looks good going all the way around there. Okay. All right, I got enough to do another one. Move this closer for you guys. Two. And now, where's the best place to put it, guys? Where you can see it. Oh, magic happening. All right, now I'm gonna do the other two.
It's time to take the tape off. So we're just gonna clip it right here. We'll do that on all four. All right. So, I mean, it's only been, 24 hours, so it's not fully cured. But it is dry. there. Now, to help make sure that the tape comes off nicely and leaves a nice line, we're going to heat it up just a little bit with the heat gun. Let me move these out of the way. So I don't know if you guys can tell so how pretty these are. So, all right, so I'm going to turn my heat gun on low. And I just want to heat. So where did my cup go? There it is. I'm going to start right there. And we're going to heat up that section of the glass. So it's still not fully cured. So that's why we can do this. Okay. And I should be able to pull this down to the line. Okay. Now, I want it to be a nice clean line, so I'm going to go ahead, now that I've got it down there and started right to where the line is, I'm going to heat this up just a little bit on the way around. Okay. So satisfying. Glass number one. Now that's going to leave a little raw edge right here. So I'm actually going to get, once I'm done with all four of them, I'm going to put my gloves on. I just one pair of gloves. And I'm going to heat it up just a little bit, and I'm going to take, I'm going to dip my finger in some alcohol just to rub and push that edge in. I'll do that all the way around, kind of like I'm doing right now. I'm gonna dip back in my alcohol just a little bit, just to help smooth out that edge, okay? And if there's any little pieces, like this one's got a little bit here where the tape was, we'll just wash that off with alcohol. But there's glass number one. Touch that line a little bit. Thank you. Now for the good part.